even just a single genome of information is a massive amount to process. So these days, if you get a genome of information, it's about 100 to 120 gigabytes of data. And again, as you start thinking of hundreds or thousands of genomes, you realize quickly that that's an enormous amount of data. Then you begin to think about what it is to analyze that amount of data. If you were to try to do this on your desktop, it would take 47 years to get it done. Whereas if you can work in a high-performance computing environment, that time now drops down to months, or better, weeks, or preferably days, and that's where we're really getting at it right now, which is to be able to look at hundreds of genomes within a couple of days and reliably call and interpret that information. The Center for Genetic Medicine was actually created in the year 2000, around the time the first genome was being sequenced, and so it was actually very forward-thinking that Northwestern, anticipating this large amount of data and data science that would be analyzed, created this center back in 2000. The Center for Genetic Medicine is a leader in this area. We've been very focused on doing whole genome analysis rather than looking at just the smaller amounts of the genome. The challenge of working with big data is to actually see the patterns and the meaningful results in the face of a whole lot of noise. One of the ways we do that in genetics is we call that very much looking for the needle in the stack of needles, because one of the things we're doing with genetics and our new approaches in genetics right now is looking at what we call rare variation. So we know that when we compare two people's genomes, there's about 15% of it that's seen with high frequency in a population, but 85% of what we look at is rare, and that's where the looking for needles in the stack of needles comes in, because we're often trying to find one out of 3 million changes that's sufficient to be causing that disease in that individual. As we think to the future, there's a large interest in collecting electronic health records and being able to use them for research purposes, and the outcomes of that will be many different areas in terms of patient safety, patient outcomes, and of course advancing the research around that. But it's a challenge to work with this degree and amount of medical records. We see more and more patients every day. We create new alliances with new hospitals, and that expands what we have in our electronic health record. And it is definitely growing exponentially. So the hardware needs are quite substantive as well. We think about terabytes and terabytes and well beyond that, petabytes of data. And keeping that data secure as well as available for researchers is a critical part of what we're doing at Northwestern. Our long-term goal with the Center for Genetic Medicine, which I hope is coming in the near-term future, is to actually use genetic information in how we make healthcare decisions, to make better decisions and to make them more precisely for the individuals that we see.